And welcome back to Let's Play Rules of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Have our tasks ahead of us. And we're going to fulfill Rymrgand's first, since that's the easiest one. We've already killed everyone inside his temple. And he's given us something to plug that wall. And I know just where that is. I don't doubt that we'll have a fight ahead of us, so I'd rather head to the Hearthsong district and get some rest. Whoop. Stop right there.
Stop right there.
We were trying to really quickly travel to that location. A soldier and Iovara. There's that Iovara person.
You're in the wrong city, Inquisitor.
The Phantom Soldier raises his short sword to your chest.
Did you think you wouldn't be recognized here, in your old home? I've seen your trials with my own eyes.
Okay, I have seen you light pyres with good people tied to them. People I'd known many a year. He seizes you by the throat, and your airway tightens, whether real or imagined you cannot tell. They deserve your confession. He raises the point of his sword, holding it a hair's breadth from your eye.
Suros, what are you doing?
Startled, the soldier releases you immediately and turns to face the speaker, a woman in a plain wool tunic, fully a head shorter than he, but somehow seeming to tower over him. You have seen this woman's face before, but from afar, bloodied and burned as she lay stretched across an iron wheel. At the moment, it is marked only with concern.
An assassin sent by the Inquisition, my lady. Daring to approach our camp.
If she is so poor an assassin as to approach an armed guard in daylight, I should have little to fear. I would hear what this woman has to say. She stares him down until he can no longer face her. He turns away, sour-faced, and pretends to be suddenly distracted by something far off.
Surely this is some trick of my mind. I did not expect to see you again.
Iovara's eyes widen as she sees your face for the first time. Well, we have all kinds of lies we can spout out, or we can say the truth. That Theos dispatched me here to spy on you. Lies. I just want to see you again. I've come to help you in any way I can. I've come to believe your teachings to be true. The evils I've done in the name of the Inquisition are too great for me to bear. I want to help you to end it. Should I lie? I mean, is this really happening, or is it we just replaying events from the past? I mean, the past shapes the present, though. I don't know. They really give us all these choices for lies and just one for the truth. Theos dispatched me here to spy on you. Well, certainly shouldn't be on Theos' side. But who is this? It's Iovara. Well, we need information, and if I just tell her that he sent me to spy on her, it's going to be over. We're not going to get information from her. I've come to believe your teachings to be true. You do realize that when your Grand Inquisitor told you to convert, he meant for you to convert other people? Any confusion aside, it is gratifying to see just how much sway the truth can hold. It is special to have an old pupil return to me. I must have done something right, even after having taught so much that was wrong. Whatever your reasons, I've missed you over all these years. Having you here now, at a time when I'm surrounded by strangers, is a wonderful gift.
I would like for you to stay here, in our camp, as my guest.
My Lady Iovara, I beg of you. This is an Inquisitor. This is a desperate attempt on your life. The only way it can succeed is if you allow it to.
No longer able to remain quiet, the soldier approaches Iovara and puts his hand on her shoulder, turning her aside. His voice is hushed, but by no means private.
This is a missionary, same as I was, taught the wrong things as I was. If I can't have faith in one woman's ability to reason, once she knows the truth, what hope do we have?
She brushes his hand away with the calm grace of the resolute.
We have many former missionaries here. They are our most loyal, our most helpful. Many have died for us. These are not people we should be turning away. And if the Inquisition wants my life, they can have it. But they know as well as I do that my cause will not die with me. Come. We have much to talk about.
Iovara beckons you somewhere behind her. Interesting. You spoke for the first time with Iovara outside Tir Everon. She welcomed you into her camp, appreciating the chance to reminisce. Okay, this is new in our journal. At the base of the two giant trees, you met a pair of Delamgan sisters. They explained to you that your cause was misguided, for no awakening can be undone. But they did still see value in your quest, explaining that if you could find the root of what troubled your soul, you might yet be able to resolve it. In either case, only Theos would have the knowledge I seek. I am to pursue him to a subterranean Inquithan city called Sun and Shadow. The Delamgan offered a path there, but it is one I will not be able to follow without the intervention of the gods. You commune with the gods in Tir Everon and learn that Theos' plot does not end with the destruction of Animancy in Deerwood. He intends to give the souls he displaced to Wutika, a move that would likely restore her dominion over the other gods. Galloway enlisted your help in forcing confrontation between a lioness and a bear, whose stalemate he found undesirable. You ensure the death of Awareness, allowing the lioness soul to continue her reign. Okay. So, he enlisted my help, but I had already done it. Interestingly enough, was the only one like that. You showed Durance that Magrin had conspired with Wutika against Eothas, and that she had intended for Durance to die along with the other engineers of the Godhammer Bomb. Durance renounced his faith in Magrin. Okay, now, for reals. Did you hear that about our awakenings being permanent? Worshippers live and breathe violence, they don't understand anything else. Alright, they were talking. Alright, I don't know. Oh, that was the warrior. Oh, he wants to talk, Aloth.
If those Delamgan are right, you and I are stuck with our awakenings. Not quite the news I was hoping for.
Gotta focus on finding Theos. Worrying won't change anything. Distrusted me too. I'm concerned about you. I swim here. I'm concerned about you. How are you taking this?
Oh, the knowledge that a barely civilized bumpkin will share my mind and body for the rest of my life? That's kind of you to ask. I'd always believed that Islamia was an ailment I could cure myself of one day. But now, to think she'll be around forever.
Well, there might be another way of getting rid of her. You mean how she's stuck with you?
You two deserve each other.
He shakes his head. And on the bright side, I've got plenty of time to figure out how to deal with her. You've got to make that decision, Aloth. What do you think?
I've been thinking about it a lot lately. About her recklessness, her unpredictability. About how my own irresolution is to blame. I need to start taking control. And that begins here.
Even as he says it, something struggles within him. The muscles in his face twitch and his skin quivers. His eyes roll back in his skull, exposing slivers of white. Sweat beads and glistens on his forehead. After several seconds, he sighs and looks back at you. That wasn't as difficult as I expected. I think, deep down, I'd always hoped to find a solution elsewhere. When I was a child, I always thought my mother would come home with a mysterious cure, or that my father, without knowing it, could somehow send her away just as he'd called her forth. I can't pretend that I didn't spend years of my arcane training hoping that one of my instructors would have the answer somewhere in his grimoire. When I joined the Leaden Key, I hoped and believed that, with enough loyal service, I'd gain the ear of someone in the organization who could help me. Even when I met you and realized your unique talents, I hoped that you might be able to reach into my soul the way I've seen you do with so many others. I'd been looking for someone else to solve my problem, and now I realize that I've got to face it on my own. Brackenbury? Oh, the sanitarium? You haven't been on your own. I got you through Brackenbury, remember?
Well, I remember well. You've been a capable leader for this expedition, and an invaluable mentor to me. I won't forget what I've learned from you.
Aw.
That reminds me of something else the Delamgon said. About the gods not being real.
A cautious, thoughtful look crosses his face. He says that quietly, as if afraid someone might overhear him. Actually, yeah, I don't know what they meant.
It's just, I can't help but worry at the state we'd be in if that were somehow true. If there were no power guiding us in this life and shepherding us to the next.
Then Isomir would just be a happy accident, and you'd have no one to blame for her.
Yes, that would take the fun out of it.
You've finally gotten control of Isomir. Do you feel any different? Just calmer, content. It's odd, for so long I fought her, lashing out at her intrusions and incursions without actually stopping her. I wasn't used to taking decisive action, and I didn't believe I'd have power over someone who had infiltrated my own mind. He smiles slowly. It was a pleasant surprise to see that I was wrong. Okay. Okay, we need to go to Old Song. Oh, crap, no. I was supposed to go to the... Hold on a second. I gotta go... I want to rest. I don't know what kind of things we're going to face there, and we're just about out of spells, and we're kind of down on hit points. Huh. Hearthsong. Right, Celestial Sapling. Ask the ogre this time. You want up? I pull. Oh, we don't? Okay. I thought he let us up if we talked to him. It was a dialogue or something.
How do you do?
Welcome back. Is there anything I can do for you? We need one camping supply, right? I think. Yeah, 4 out of 4 it shows here. All these tomes. We've memorized every spell that he didn't know. Books. Look at all these lockpicks we got. We haven't picked a lock in a while, haven't we? This is the one about Whitaker. Let you guys pause and read this if you want. I've already read it. I'm gonna glance through it really quick. Okay, so Whitaker's looking to take back her throne. Remind myself here. Goddess of justice, law, oaths, promises, rulership, vengeance, memory, and hierarchies. Depicted as an old noblewoman bearing a broken crown upon her head, said to have been once ruled over the other gods, but has since been overthrown. So what kind of justice is this if she's preying upon innocent people and taking their souls?
Welcome!
That's not justice. Something with a nice view, yes? Plus 1 resolve, plus 1 for survival, plus 2 might, constitution. Oh, yeah, get this. Alright, done. Let's head on. Back to old song. Should have gone there and just crossed, but whatever. That's a few seconds more. Of course you can't go there. You know, how do we go to North Weald? I guess we have to go there from Old Song. Okay.
Kana, I just remembered an old Valian song. Maybe it was Dwarven. From when I was a girl.
Really? Let's hear it!
Vanimbe metse, vanimbe metse, senete de luches, senete de luches. Do you know it?
No, I'm afraid I can't say I've ever heard that particular tune.
I think she sings beautifully. Are you surprised, Kana? Noonfrost. I think we have to get to that place from, actually from Old Song's Pass. Might have caught the first syllable, missed the first syllable of what she was saying, so I decided to quickly restart the recording. Because there were a few jerky frames. Well, the frames per second were a little jerky, and that throws the audio out of sync, and that happened a few episodes ago. I hate that. That's the gate. Place should be empty. Unless it's been repopulated. So far, so good. The White Void. Finally, I found the Frost-Hewn Breach. Placing the shard in the frozen doorway will close it. Oh, that? A pedestal of black ice rises from the floor. Long, finger-like ice crystals, as hard and clear as diamond, surrounded, pierce the altar. A hole has been gouged out of the middle of the altar. Though it can't be more than a few inches deep, it sucks at the air around you. Plug the hole with Rymrgand's shard, actually, pronounced. The shard fits perfectly. As it settles into place, the cold around the altar dissipates. Similarly, the portal before you seems to thicken, and the mysterious seepage tapers off. I've completed the task Rymrgand gave me. Now I can return to Tyr Everon to ask for his blessing. The Frost-Hewn Breach lies dormant, now nothing more than a perfectly smooth wall of ice. Okay. If nothing interesting happens, I'll see you guys back at Tyr Everon. Okay, Rymrgand. You pray again, and the vision of the white plain emerges. The driving wind returns in a chaos of whirling snow. Something moves at the center of the blizzard, plodding but relentless. As the snowstorm gets closer, you see an aurochs, as colossal and slow as a glacier. Its shaggy white hair is matted with frost, but beneath it, ribs like a ship's frame protrude. Kana says, "The Beast of Winter. I've seen its shape prowling the walls of many an ancient ruin." A man, I guess named Skein, emaciated and almost naked, huddles at the beast's legs. His body is scored with lash marks, and his nose and ears have been carved from his face. His black eyes pierce the white out. Yeah, I thought that name sounded familiar. Aloth leans forward. By the wheel, It's Skein. I don't remember though, guys. I know he's from a while back. Skein. Hope I figure it out. The aurochs stops and stands before you, enveloping you in the violent blizzard that surrounds it. Though its mouth does not move, the beast speaks in a deep, thunderous voice.
A clan of Glamfellen ventured from the White that Wends to find the crack in the ice. When you sealed it, you damned their souls to a slow weathering here. One they had sought to escape.
Their recklessness endangered the rest of Old Song.
For each there is a season watcher. Winter's shroud covers all things in its time. The heat and energy of life dissipates, and untethered essence fades into chaos. But entropy is a chisel of ice and a hammer of wind. It is not for mortals to wield these tools.
Skein snickers. The world shudders beneath you, and a great crack echoes across the white expanse. The ice splits at your feet, waves lapping through the rift.
The Watcher seeks something long lost. What is it you search for?
So that's Andra. A low, melancholy voice rises from the depths. Well, choice one is definitely a worthy choice. But really, we started out by looking for two and three, because, well, we didn't know about the thousands of souls. Understanding of who I was and what my past means now.
Your past is one of loss and sorrow. The key to it is Theos, a man who has been forgotten to you for many lifetimes.
Yet there is a greater plot at work here, Watcher. Theos acts not for himself. He is the Burned Queen's quiet slave, a master of secrets and schemes.
Theos is a winter gale. Unseen by the world even while he carves and shapes it. Woodica directs him, sending him to wipe her enemies from Iovara.
And Animancy as well. He would see those secrets lost, the knowledge forgotten.
Oh, Skein is the one the Skeinites follow. Well, he's a god as well. So why is he this whipped little man around at Rymrgand's foot? Is Rymrgand really that much more powerful than he? Or is that his form really a representation of who he, his followers, who are slaves, and considered small compared to their masters? Pelagina turns to you and speaks softly through a smug grin. If I don't make it through this, assuming it's not too much to ask, please tell the Dukes that I did tell them so.
And he would see his mistress grow fat on the essence of thousands. For her, he has harvested the unborn souls of the Deerwood.
It's impossible to tell whether Skein's ragged expression is a smile or a snarl. What does Woodica want with these souls?
To consume them. To collect her evaporating power, rebuilding what the turning ages have stripped from her.
The gaunt aurochs seem to sigh as freezing winds tug at its fur.
She would reclaim her status like an island of silt dredged from the sea.
With this fresh, raw essence, Wudica will seize power over those gods and kith who have refused to acknowledge her authority. The ultimate act of vengeance.
Why does Theos hate animancy?
He believes that some knowledge is best lost to mortals.
The waves break quietly against the ice for several seconds.
More importantly, Wudica despises it, and he yields to the will of the exiled queen in all things.
Aloth says, I recognize his methods have been questionable, but mightn't he be right? As usual, when our companions speak, we completely ignore them. What now?
Theos has removed these souls from the cycle. They are ice melting in the sun. Let them fade.
Rymrgand's deep, slow voice echoes across the glacier. Let them fade.
Let them forget this world and be forgotten by it.
Waves crash in agreement. Well, that's right, Andra's the goddess of the sea.
Take the souls she so desires and grind them into dust. Let her see her careful schemes thoroughly ruined.
Skane grins, still huddled next to one of the beast's woolly legs. Kanna says, ground to dust, is it? This skulking thing, at least, is honest. I like not the sound of this. For several moments, the waves wash quietly against the ice, and the aurochs stand silently amidst the churning flurries.
It is the destiny of all things to crumble and join the chaos that follows this world. Some seek it willingly, as you have seen.
To mingle, roiled and stirred by the tides of the universe. It is not an unkind fate.
Why do you oppose Wudica?
She desires to order chaos and shackle the agents of change in the world. Under her, all things would remain static and frozen according to her laws.
The aurochs shakes its hoary mane, exposing its prominent ribs.
Even now, she only barely keeps the pact of the gods to leave the affairs of kith in mortal hands. She moves in Theos where she cannot move directly.
And so we call on you to do the same. Such are the schemes of the queen that was.
Skane's laughter is thin and shrill. Somehow he couldn't hear it. You would give these souls the very fate you sought to deny the Glamfellen pilgrims.
I am the Beast of Winter. I neither speed nor alter my path for the whims and desires of kith. I take souls at the time of my choosing, be it mote by mote or in a sudden tempest of chaos.
These souls, they have already forgotten their place in this world. They have been lost to existence. Let them be memorialized and mourned for an age and then forgotten entirely.
I'll seek Theos in Sun and Shadow.
When you reach the burial isle, we will send lost souls to guide you through the pit. This is our gift to you. What you do after you face Theos will be your choice, but we would have you set the stolen essence adrift.
Do we get to choose?
And whether you would heed us or no, understand that our end comes to all things eventually. Help us achieve it, and we shall reward you now with a power to rival Theos's.
Do we get to hear the words of the other two gods first?
But do not choose lightly. We forget nothing, least of all a betrayal.
I would hear what the other gods have to say first.
Do not wait forever. We wait, but Theos does not.
Rymrgand continues toward you, swallowing you in a blinding, deafening snowstorm. you experience a dizzying, exhilarating disorientation, oblivious to the landscape around you and even the reality of your own body. You hear a noise that could be the shrieking winds or Skane's screeching cackle, and then it recedes with everything else. Rymrgand appears in the distance, trudging away from you, and the whiteout follows him. As the vision of snow fades, it leaves in its wake the flagstones of Tir Evron. I closed the Frost-Hewn Breach in Noonfrost and prevented Glamfellen and his clan from passing through it. Rymrgand, Andra, and Skane were pleased and have promised to help me descend the pit to Sun and Shadow. Well, we have some more quests to fulfill. For Barath, we have two. Is it two? Wait a second. Right. I know who he is. It's not saying here, but I know he's in the Blood Sands. We met him. We found him there. And he did have that eerily smooth face, like there had been wrinkles that had been erased and had come back and erased and come back. And the other, so we have to go to Blood Sands and we have to go to Elmshore. I mean, maybe we're meant to go to Elmshore first. Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. Yeah, we're gonna take that on first before we go and fulfill Helia's quest, which is actual dragon. So we're not gonna do that just yet. This so reminds me of the Neverwinter symbol. Well, thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.